We create our world every single day. Wherever you and me are today, we have created it ourselves and nobody else. And wherever you and me will be in months and years to come, that also nobody else is creating for us. We are creating that also every single day. I was going through an interesting book by a Buddhist teacher from South Korea, Haemin Sunim. And in that book, Sunim made a very profound observation. And he said, the world around us is huge. There are so many people, things, situations, phenomena happening at the same time that if your mind starts registering each and everything, probably you will go mad. So instead, your mind has found a very smart way of representing the world to you. Whatever you constantly think about, your mind starts giving you and starts showing you more of that. And in a way, your mind starts creating your own world. Let me give you an example. You want to buy a new car, maybe a red color Swift car, Maruti Suzuki Swift car, red color. Probably before you made this decision, you might not have even noticed that there are red color Swifts around. But the moment you decide to buy a red color Swift car for yourself, after that point, you will start seeing red color Swift cars everywhere. This happens not only with cars, this happens with maybe a new mobile you want to buy, or a laptop you want to buy, or a new brand of t-shirts you want to buy. Like whenever you decide to buy something, you are in the process of deciding whether to buy or not to buy. Your mind will start collecting more and more of those things and start showing to you. So your world is unique, my world is unique. Even though you and me can be brothers or friends or neighbors, but your mind will show you the world that will resonate with what you are thinking, and my mind will show me the world that will resonate with what I am thinking. Hundreds of years ago, Buddha said, mind is everything, whatever you think you become. 1903, there was a guy, his name was James Allen, and he wrote a book called As a Man Thinketh. And from 1903 to 2021 today, when I'm doing this TEDx talk, right now also the same small book and the principles given in that book are still valid, which says, as the man thinketh in his heart, so is he. Fundamentally, wherever I am today, wherever you are today, we have created it with our constant thinking. So therefore, the good news is, if you want to change your world, you don't need to worry about the world. You need to worry about your thinking. Just change your thinking and your world will change. There was a very powerful woman. She has done a lot of work in self-help and personal development. The name of the woman was Louise Hay. And Louise Hay once said, I don't fix problems. I fix my thinking and problems fix themselves. I'll give you one more story. Very interesting one. I listened it from my Guruji. So there was once a vice president of a multinational company. This guy was pretty successful. He was among top corporate executives in his industry, and he has been traveling around the world. And after 2-3 weeks, he got one holiday. He got one Sunday off. He was reading his favorite newspaper, having a cup of chai, and enjoying his day. While he got a Sunday after 2-3 weeks, his son got his dad after 2-3 weeks. So his son was playing around him, and every 5 or 10 minutes, the son will come to the father and will ask, father, please play with me. Father, please play with me. And father was relaxing. He was not in the mood for anything else. He wanted to read the newspaper. But son was constantly pestering him, play with me, play with me, play with me, play with me. So this guy, he was a vice president and he knew how to handle situations. So he suddenly got an idea. The newspaper that he was reading had a world map. You know, there was some company which was showing it their locations, their operations across the globe, and world map was there on the newspaper. He took that newspaper and he tore it into multiple pieces and he handed over to the son. And he said, my dear, let us play a game together. I have given you a world map. You fix it back. And make sure every country and every location is its own original place. The moment you fix this map, I will start playing with you. And this vice president was so confident that he has torn it into so many pieces that nobody on earth probably can fix it in 6, 8, 10 hours. But within 10 minutes, the boy came running and he said, Dad, I have fixed the world. And this guy was astonished. He was stunned. And he looked really, really carefully what is the position of India, China, maybe America, Japan? And he was surprised that every country was in its own place. So he asked his son, how did you manage this? He said, Dad, it was very simple. So behind the world map that you gave me, there was an image of a man. I didn't worry about the world. I fixed the man. The world got fixed itself. I fixed the man. The world was fixed. The same holds true for us also. If we want to change the world around us, we don't need to worry about the world. We need to fix this, our own mind. And what do I mean when I say we need to fix our mind? It's very simple. We need to fix our thinking. I tell you, my dear friends, if one thing you can do for yourself and for the world is to think for yourself. Trust me on this. Think for yourself. Everybody around you, be it your parents, be it your colleagues, be it your teachers, be it your professors, probably me or maybe every religious leader, every political leader, everybody has got their opinion and everybody has got their own ideas of the world and they are trying to force those ideas on you. One thing that you need to do and you need to make sure that you do it for yourself and nobody else, and that is to think for yourself. And if you want to craft a masterpiece life for yourself, then you need to take responsibility of your own thinking. If you also resonate with this idea that you are creating your own world with your own thoughts, I can give you very quickly 6 key areas of your life where you need to start thinking for yourself to create a life of your dreams. Area number 1, living your best life every day. My idea of a good life is very simple. Your life is measured in days. If you want to have a good quality of life, you need to have good quality of days. You need to spend the days in the best possible way. You need to decide for yourself, what do you mean by best? What do you mean by success? And you need to have your own parameters of a good day, of a good life, of good work. You need to define for yourself what gives you highest level of joy, satisfaction, and meaning. Let me repeat it for you. You need to define for yourself what kind of a life, what kind of a daily action you need to do that will give you highest level of joy, satisfaction, and meaning. And you need to do more of it. You want to be happy? My coach says, very simple, do more of what makes you happy, not what others feel will make you happy. There's a small distinction here. You need to do more of what makes you happy, not what others think that will make you happy. So your parents, your teachers, your neighbors, your colleagues, peer groups, social media, everybody is trying to put a label on what is the meaning of a good life for you. You need to question everything and define the meaning of a good life for yourself and then live it every single day. One of the key skills you need to develop for living a good life is the skill of asking the right questions. Remember that, my dear friends, quality of your life depends on the quality of questions that you ask. You ask good questions, life will give you good answers and you will have a good life. You ask lousy questions, life will give you lousy answers and you will have a lousy quality of life. You know, so never compare yourself to anybody. Don't let anybody put labels on you. And I feel very strongly about one thing. That is, if you compare yourself to anybody else, you are insulting yourself. And not only are you insulting yourself, you are insulting your creator also. So decide what is the meaning of a good life, good day, good work, and then go for it and live that every single day. Number 2, choose your goals yourself. Choose your goals yourself. Decide what exactly you want to do in life. I have close to 1,000,000+ people following me from 100 different countries in the world. And one question I get asked repeatedly is, what kind of a career should I choose? I mean, honestly speaking, you are the only one who can answer this question. What kind of a career you should choose? What kind of goals you should set for yourself? You need to take a stand and you need to decide for yourself. Whatever gives you highest level of satisfaction, whatever you want to do rest of your life, you should choose that kind of a career and that kind of a goal for yourself. After I finished my 10th standard, I wanted to become a doctor. 2 years I tried but couldn't become a doctor. I mean, couldn't really qualify for that. I changed my stream, shifted from science to commerce, and then I went for MBA. Cleared my CAT exam and did my MBA. After finishing my MBA, I got campus placement to a multinational automobile company, and at the age of 25, I became regional manager in that company. I worked for 4 years, then I thought, maybe let me go for entrepreneurship, and I started building my own business. 2018, I published my first book and it became a bestseller. Then 2018, I thought, why not share my ideas with the world through videos? And I started my YouTube channel and I started putting content on Instagram. Now, I have 3 books and all 3 are bestsellers. I have a following of 1 million plus people across the world. I have my own training and consulting company where we offer a lot of courses and a lot of programs. Why I could do so many things with my life? Reason is very simple. At every point of time, I defined the meaning of success and career for myself, and I chose what gave me highest level of satisfaction and went with that. Third area of your life where you need to use your own thinking is preparing yourself for achieving your life goals. You have decided your life goals. Now you need to find out gaps. You know, every next level of success demands a next level of mindset, skill set, tool set, competency, emotional mastery. So once you define the goals, after that you need to decide what exactly you need to become to achieve that goal. Right? And then you need to start preparing for it. Every goal demands a different level of preparation. Now, if you want to play for your school or play for the district, this preparation will be entirely different if you want to play for Olympics. So don't let people tell you what is good for you, what is not good for you, how you should prepare and all those things. Decide your goals, find out gaps, and then start preparing for it. You know, and every time you're preparing, keep asking this question. Continuously question everything and keep asking, how can I learn better? How can I learn faster? How can I do this thing better? How can I do this thing faster? Fourth area, very, very important. And you can only succeed in life if you start thinking for yourself in this fourth area. And that is, how do you handle setbacks on the way to your dreams? How do you handle setbacks? Because setbacks are normal. Challenges are part of the journey. I mean, this is how you grow. When you don't grow when you are at the top of the mountain, you grow in the process of climbing the mountain. It's very simple. Somebody told me a few years back when I was not doing well as an entrepreneur. I mean, I was failing back to back. And this guy, he told me that failure is a feedback. Failure will teach you invaluable lessons. A mistake is not a problem. Making a mistake is not a problem. But if you repeat the mistake, then it is a problem. Then it's no longer a mistake. Then it's a decision, right? So anytime you set your eyes on a goal, you're not able to achieve that, don't worry about it. Just see what is the issue and then you resolve that issue and handle setbacks beautifully with your own thinking. Fifth area of your life where you need to think for yourself is achievement, handling achievement. Every achievement is a great opportunity to think again. With every achievement, ask yourself, are you feeling happy? Are you feeling accomplished? What have you got? And when you achieve a goal, the question is not what have you got? The question is what have you become in the process of achieving that? And this brings me to the sixth area of your life. That is next goals. Next goals. My Guruji always tells me this thing. The question is not from where here. The question is from here, where. Every time you achieve one goal, start thinking of the next one. Start thinking of the next one and make constant growth, constant progress a part of your daily living philosophy. So the game is very simple, my friend. At each stage in your life and every day of your life, you need to think for yourself and constantly evolve and grow. Always remember, you are creating your own world every single day with your own thoughts. The moment you decide to change your thinking, your world will start changing. I wish you all the very best in this journey of self-discovery and creating a new you. You can give anything to anybody, but never give them permission to think for yourself, because that's your birthright. So think for yourself and create a beautiful world, a world of your dreams for yourself. All the best. Keep shining.